had a little bit of a break.
They're away
here. Stabs the ball inside 50 to clinch. Ivan's beside him, takes the hand pass from 60, drives long. Alloway has position.
Oh!
Alloway takes a one-hander. He took it away from Ferguson quite brilliantly. Daniel Kerr went on a 360. He handballed it into the path of Wright, who picked it up, and somehow he smuggled it to Young, who went inside 50. Great one-hander taken by Hartlett. And his defensive post quickly spreads the ball wide. McCready
didn't play footy, but on that occasion, I reckon he thought he was 10 metres clear there, guys.
Shane Burse at half-back, grandstand side. It's a two-on-one contest, and the numbers are with North Adelaide, but Ferguson.
With a great inboard hand pass, Caruso sold the dummy, and then inboard he went. And inside half-forward, Laird goes with a kick.
Oh!
Fisher at the back, Brad Fisher. Has a chance to with Gorman, they work it out, and Ivans clears it to the far side of the ground.
Jimmy
where Izard, the McGarry medalist, takes the mark.
Oh,
he's
the
quickly
kick.
Back to his feet. It wasn't a great kick, but it
back in board. North Adelaide going long and deep up towards the goal square, just slipped through the fingers of Boris. 1-2, couldn't quite get it. Has a flying shot at the goals on the recovery, all third time lucky. And suddenly the Roosters are out to a 14-point lead. They are 4-3-27.
There, just put it up, give it a bit of air, let him run onto it as he did there. Need his best kick here.
Fisher comes around a bit, tries to hook it around.
There's
his best kick, all right.
Oh.
It's again a 9-point margin. Westies get one back. Ball in the air, about five ruckmen. Well, we'll call them ruckmen. They're all looking for the tap. Ben Fisher struggles his way through and gets a goal. Well, he was almost tackled. And he struggled his way through and snapped with the right boot.
Whiz, the player got met very heavily after he got rid of the ball. And again, the ball up towards half forward and a screamer of a mark taken there by Phillips. That was a rip snorter. Went up before acceptance, and what more important, it was an actual fact, but the Pies have got it. They're going to kick it back. Oh, Donoghue, courage. The ball was high. He kept his eyes on the footy. That might be a 25-metre penalty. Got put down for no reason at all. That silly football there. By
bowling. Green here.
Should kick this one after the exact same spot as last time.
Yes, and he's kicked it long and high, and he has put it in the right over the top of the right-hand goalpost, and it's just drifted away with his...
It's a high ball towards the full forward. The ball tapped away. Here's an opportunity now for the red legs to kick towards goal. Clever. Pick up the player for you in a minute. It might have been Kirkwood, was it?
Banner,
was it? Yep. Very clever kick. Over the back, though, the ball comes. The red leg should be there. No, great speed. The art, you think it is, has got the footy. Goes bang from about 40 metres and drills it. Straight through the high middle. Devil, terrific football. Speed out of the block.
35 metres out. Very sharp angle on the boundary on that outer side. Comes in now. Kick is on its way. And he has kicked that goal. What a magnificent kick by Sutherton. And that is his second. And Porto now have got their 10th. They got a 10.
Great skills, great awareness. I'm afraid to go at the bottom of the pack. There's one down there by Koshel Dewey, but he snaps at the goals, and he snaps a goal. So Brett Ebert gets the important one for Port Adelaide as we're 40 seconds into the
25-minute mark of this final term. He'll go short again. The kick is miscued and comes to Brown. Brown will kick around the body. Look pretty good off the boot. It is. Another goal to the red legs. Just always fraught with danger when you... go short in the defensive 50, Darryl Smith.
Of course, should have asked you about the cooking. Who does that? This time it's going to be the Eagles swinging the ball right up in towards the teeth of goal. Goldsworthy, beautiful use of the body there. And Goldsworthy has taken the mark. 40 metres.
Bays whack it out towards half-back. But the Eagles again showing some running through Day, who puts the Woodville West Torrens side back inside 50. But Rudolph takes a good defensive mark. He hands off there to Curran of Woodville Oval. And Cully comes in and grabs the football, plays on, kicks up to 50, but Glenelg have the numbers, and a very nice mark by Pitt, who slowly got into this game. See Glenelg inside their 50. They break away here from the bounce down. It was nice work there from Lyons, from McGinty hit out, got a handball off to Bradley, who snaps the goal from 45 out on the run, and the Bays get their first through Bradley.
Ball, the red-headed Agnew in towards centre-half forward. He's the only Agnew out there, but the red hair just stands out. Lyons has got the ball. He lines it up and he puts it through. Glenelg on fire at the moment, this young Glenelg team. And young Jared, I reckon Agnew might be one that AFL clubs will look at. He looks all right, 19 years of age, races through the half-forward line, goes with his left foot. Terrific effort. Agnew there has kicked a goal. What a great effort. And he's kicked only his fourth goal in his 20th. 20-
We saw Raymond in the first half playing in defence, moved into the forward line in the second half. His kick looks reasonable. That's a goal. Well done, Raymond. Well done, the Eagles. 8.5 minutes gone, final term.
Perhaps they're gathered here by Agnew, who's been a terrific player today for Glenelg. Up they go. Hender was the leaper from behind. And then he kicks the ball through for a goal. He went up. The ball seemed to spill out of his hands, and it just...